that nothing in life is worthwhile unless you take risks. Nothing. Nelson Mandela said, "There is no passion to be found playing small and settling for a life that's less than the one you're capable of living." Now, I'm sure in your experiences in school and applying to college and picking your major and deciding what you want to do with life, I'm sure people have told you to make sure you have something to fall back on. Make sure you got something to fall back on, honey. But I never understood that concept, having something to fall back on. If I'm going to fall, I don't want to fall back on anything. I want to fall forward. I figure at least this way I'll see what I'm going to hit. Without consistency, you'll never finish. So do what you feel passionate about. Take chances. Don't be afraid to fail. There's an old IQ test was 9 dots, and you had to draw 5 lines with a pencil within these 9 dots without lifting the pencil. The only way to do it was to go outside the box. Don't be afraid to think outside the box. Don't be afraid to fail big, to dream big. But remember, dreams without goals are just dreams. Reggie Jackson struck out 2,600 times in his career, the most in the history of baseball. But you don't hear about the strikeouts. People remember the home runs. Fall forward. Thomas Edison conducted 1,000 failed experiments. Did you know that? I didn't know that. Because the 1,001st was the light bulb. Fall forward.
in order to be successful in life, you have to cross a jungle. Or you can stay on the other side of the jungle and not cross the jungle. But if you choose to cross the jungle has all sorts of things that can do you harm and bite you and everything along those lines. And so the best way to do that is to go into that with people who can see things differently and watch themselves and struggle to make it to the other side. And then what I've discovered along the way is that it's always a struggle and I enjoy being in the jungle.
My unflagging belief in one simple thing, I can learn anything.
I think people have to realize that they have to accept failure, but don't accept defeat. I think whenever you're trying to do something great, whenever you're trying to be successful, you're going to face failures, you know, but it's those lessons in the failures that really take you to greatness.
My entire reality was based on what I believed was real and what I believed was true about myself, about what's possible, and that I could change that. That's when my life started to change. And he said, if you start to change the way you think and you start to learn every day for 1 hour to upgrade your knowledge and your skills, and then you take action every day on the things that are the most important instead of all the different things that you can do, 1 year, you'll be at a totally different destination. 5, 10 years, your life won't be the same.
So what would be best for you 3 to 5 years down the road if you were really taking care of yourself like you were someone that you thought should be around? And people are very ambivalent about whether they should be around, so this is a lot harder than you think. So you need that vision. And then what you also need is a vision of what your life would be like if you let yourself deteriorate in precisely the foolish ways that you know that you would deteriorate if you let yourself go. And that's contemplation too. It's like, okay, if I let myself go, where would I end up?
Haven't developed grit yet. And so grit is the ability to persevere, to see things through, to go past the point at which it has stopped being fun and it becomes boring because you believe in your end goal enough, you're excited by what you're trying to accomplish so much that you're willing to fight through all of that difficulty. You're willing to fight through the boredom, you're willing to fight through the unease that arises when you step outside your comfort zone, you're doing things you're not good at, and things that are boring. Those are the two things that I find kill most people. They just cannot handle the things that make them go, oh God, like I'm not very good at this and I'm feeling really badly about myself. And they forget that they can get good on a long enough timeline. And then two, inevitably, in any pursuit of greatness, in any endeavor where you're trying to gain mastery, you're gonna get bored. Because practice is repetition. It's doing something over and over and over and over to really train yourself to get to the point where you're truly exceptional, and there's just so much boredom inherent in that process.
Primarily, we learn the most about ourselves and others when we're uncomfortable. Because the moment you move into that uncomfortable state, normally a program jumps in. And that program jumps in is because the person doesn't want to be in the present moment and engage it consciously. That is what starts the process of change. And so we have to unlearn before we relearn. We have to break the habit of the old self before we reinvent the new self. We have to unmemorize emotions that are stored in the body, then recondition the body to a new mind and to a new emotion.
Progress to just keep getting better. Little incremental gains every day, every week, every month, every quarter. And even when you move backwards a couple of steps, what's the progress that you made in what you learned? So I was taught that failure is an opportunity to learn. And I was also taught to disassociate me being a failure from failing.
If you get yourself in a state of certainty that this is gonna work, I'm gonna find a way, and if this doesn't work, I will make the way, then you tap a lot more potential. And when you're certain in your potential, you take massive action. When you take massive action, you really believe in something, you get great results.
Because the long-term impact of making a decision from your heart and soul, that is where the best life comes from.